While going through the concepts of finite element method, one thing you must have realized is there will be a lot of integrations over this for this course. And then to make our life easy, we have something called as numerical integration. Now there are many methods under this numerical integration by which we can evaluate the given integral. But if you go through the literature of finite element, then one will come to know that the Gauss quadrature integral or Gaussian quadrature integral is the most preferred numerical integration method in case of finite element method. So what exactly it does is, if I look at the formula of Gaussian quadrature integral in one dimension, if I have say a function which goes from minus 1 to 1, and if I want to evaluate this, what I can do is I can approximate it with this formula here. Now, although this looks a bit fancy formula, but what actually it tells us is I need not evaluate this function over the entire domain which goes from minus 1 to plus 1. But what I can do is I can evaluate this function at only some points which are called as Gauss points and multiply with corresponding weights which are called as Gauss weights. And then this product, if we sum it up over the total number of Gaussian points or Gauss points, I will get the value of this integral exactly. And then to understand it in much better way, what we will do is, this is what I meant, this is the function f of xi, and it goes from minus 1 to plus 1. And then what we will be doing is we will be evaluating the value of this f of xi not over the entire domain but only at some specific points within this domain, only at some specific points, let us say this point or this point or this point, some specific point, only at those points we will evaluate this value of f of xi, and we will multiply it with some corresponding weights and we will sum it up. So this xi values, that is the Gauss point values and the weight values, can be summarized in this table. So this is the table of Gauss points and weights. So say if we require n points, if we require n points to evaluate the given integral exactly, then for those points we have the corresponding Gauss points and weights. Now if you go through the any numerical mathematics textbook, you will find the way how to get these Gauss points. Fine, but in case of finite element method, we don't require that. We will just have to remember some values in order to evaluate any given integral. So what we will do is, we'll straight away take one example and we will see how actually this method works. So here I have an example, and I need to evaluate this. I need to evaluate this integral, this integral from domain, over the domain which goes from 4 to 8. Now if you compare this given integral with this Gauss quadrature formula, we observe one thing, that this domain only varies from minus 1 to plus 1, whereas this domain varies from 4 to 8. So in this case, we cannot really apply this Gauss quadrature numerical formula directly to this integral because our domains are not same. In fact, we had studied in our previous classes that how to change the coordinate system, that is if I have a coordinate system in terms of global coordinate, then how to change it in terms of the natural coordinate which varies from minus 1 to plus 1. And to do that, we had seen that this x, that is the global coordinate, can be written as l times xi plus xi plus xj divided by 2. Right, we had seen this. Further, this L is nothing but xj minus xi, and this divided by 2 xi, plus I can write this as xj plus xi divided by 2. So this is the relation between the natural coordinate and the global coordinate. And if I use this relation, I can transfer this domain which is from 4 to 8 in terms of minus 1 to 1, and that is what exactly has been shown here, that this domain which varies from xi to xj can be mapped to this natural coordinate which goes from minus 1 to 1 by using this formula over here. Fine. So what we will do is, the moment you see any integral and you want to evaluate it using Gauss quadrature integral, first check its domain. If it is from minus 1 to plus 1, you can straight away use this formula. If it is not, then by using this relation, we will have to change this domain from minus 1 to plus 1. Fine. And that can be done by using this. So basically, this, the moment you are using this, the limits will be changed from minus 1 to plus 1. So let us see now what will be the value of this x in terms of xi. So we have here x as, here our xj is 8 and xi is 4. So this will be 8 minus 4 divided by 2 xi plus 8 plus 4 divided by 2. And if I try to evaluate this, this will be 4 by 2 xi plus 12 by 2, and this will give me 6 plus 2 xi. So our x is 6 plus 2 xi. And also, if I try to evaluate what is dx by dxi will be equal to, dx by dxi will be equal to 2, and therefore our dx is nothing but 2 times dxi. Now if I substitute this values here, that is, in place of x, if I substitute x plus 2 xi, and in place of dx I substitute 2 times dxi, our limit will change from minus 1 to plus 1, and therefore our new integral I will be equal to, from minus 1 to plus 1, from minus 1 to plus 1, in place of x, now we have 6 plus 2 xi whole cube plus 6 plus 2 xi square, again plus 6 plus xi, and this whole bracket multiplied by, in place of dx, we have 2 times dxi. Now this is the time when we will decide how many number of Gauss points do we require, whether it is now 1 number of Gauss points or 2 number of Gauss points or 3 number of Gauss points or let us see how many number of Gauss points we will require. Gauss points means we had seen that from this formula that we will not be evaluating this integral over the entire domain, but we will find the value of this function only at certain Gauss points. So if this n turns out to be 1, we will be using only one Gauss point over this function, and that will be located at xi I equal to 0. So we will evaluate this function only at this point, and then we will multiply it by the corresponding weight, and that's it. That will be our answer. But if I get this value of n as 2, then we'll have to go for the two Gauss point. One is located at minus 0.57735, that will be somewhere here, and the second one is located at plus 0.57735, that will be somewhere, it will be located somewhere here. So basically, if n turns out to be 2, what we'll do is we'll find the value of this function at these two points, that is at here and here, then we will multiply this value with corresponding weights, and then we'll sum them up. If I get the value of n as 3, then what we will do is we will try to calculate the value of this function at xi equal to 0, that is at this point, and then at this point, so it will be somewhere here, and then this point, which will be somewhere here, and then we'll multiply it by corresponding weights. Or say if we get the value of n as 4, then we'll have to evaluate it at four different points. So first two points are minus 0.3, which will be somewhere here, and then the second point is plus 0.3, which will be somewhere here, then we have minus 8, which will be somewhere here, plus 8, which will be somewhere, plus 0.8, which will be somewhere here, and so on. So basically, when I say I get n as 4, I will have to evaluate this integral at these 4 points, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then I'll have to multiply it by these corresponding weights, and then again sum them up. So this is basically what is our Gauss quadrature integral. So, and then our question will be now how to find this n, how to decide how many points, Gauss points we need to fix. And then to answer that, we have here a thumb rule. It says that the location of this Gauss points and weights are derived in such a way that with n points, so with n points, we will be able to evaluate the polynomial of degree 2n minus 1 exactly. So that means if I have a polynomial of degree 2n minus 1, so in this case, if I have a polynomial of degree say 2n minus 1, so here our degree of polynomial is 3, because 3 is the highest degree here in the entire polynomial, because this will be xi cube. Here it will be xi square. So highest degree is 3. So 2n minus 1 here is 3. So from here we can find how many Gauss points, that is n, we will require, and that tells us that 2n is 4. So therefore our n will be equal to 2. So we require only 2 Gauss points in order to evaluate this integral exactly. So that means I will be integrating this at 2 points, that is at Gauss point minus 0.57735 and at Gauss point plus 0.57735. So I will have to evaluate this integral, entire integral, at f of xi I, that is xi I will be here minus 0.57757735 and plus 0.57735. So let us substitute these values in this. So f of xi i will be equal to, once it will be equal to this, so it will be 6 plus 2 times minus 0.57735, then it will be cube plus 6 plus 2 times minus 0.57735, it will be square, plus 6 plus minus 0.57735. And then if I evaluate this value, I will get this value as 284.1499. We need to remember that we also have here a 2, so I will have to multiply this by 2. So this will be our f of xi I at this point. So our value of this function at this point, that is minus 0.57735, has turned out to be this. And then we'll have to further multiply this value by its corresponding weight, right? Because that is our formula. We have to multiply this by corresponding weight. So corresponding weight for this Gauss point is 1. So finally we'll get this wi multiplied by f of xi I is equal to 284.1499 multiplied by 1, which is again 284.1499. Now we'll have to again evaluate this at the second Gauss point, that is at 0.57735 plus 0.57735, and that will be equal to, again, only thing is in place of minus 0.57735 in this equation, I'll have to substitute plus 0.57735, and that will give me value as 849.1833, and then again I will have to multiply this value by corresponding weight of this Gauss function, this Gauss point, and that is also here is equal to 1. So again wi multiplied by f of xi I will be equal to 849.1833. So I can just write this here as 1, and I can even write this as 2, that is also fine. So finally, after getting this, what we have to do is we have to sum them up from I equal to 1 to n. So in this case, n becomes 2. So wi f of xi I. So this is nothing but this means it is w1 f of xi 1 plus w2 f of xi 2. And this will finally give me the value as 1133.33332. So this is the value which I'm getting by integrating this function numerically. And if I just compare this with the exact solution, so this is what I have obtained from numerical integration. But if I compare it with exact value, if I compare it with exact value, I will get this as 1133.333333. So this is very close. So if I just follow this guideline of choosing the number of points, that is, if the degree of polynomial is 2n minus 1, then I require n points to evaluate this integral exactly. If I follow that guideline, I can easily evaluate this integral, or any integral for that matter, to the very precise value. To remember this Gauss points, I can even write this values as 1/√3, and this value is nothing but -1/√3. Similarly, this value, this for 3-point formula, this value here can be written as can be written as -√0.6. And this will be +√0.6. This is just to remember. And then this value can be also written as 5/9, and this value can be written as 8/9. Again, this value will be 5/9, because at least up to n3 we'll have to remember in order to answer any problem in your exams. So this is how we can evaluate this integral by using Gauss quadrature integral. Now, whatever steps we have done here is fine for, say, just for n equal to 2 or smaller or very few number of Gauss points. If I have a very large number of Gauss points, then better to put all these calculations, whatever we have done, in a table in a following fashion. That is this table. And then here we just need to write the number of Gauss points. Here we had got the number of Gauss points as 2, so I will have to write here 1 and 2, and then the corresponding Gauss points xi for first Gauss point xi I was -0.57735, so I will write it here -0.57735. Our second Gauss point was +57735. Then we will have to evaluate this function and write the value of this function. We had evaluated at this point, we had evaluated the function value as 284.1499. That I will have to write here, 284.1499. And at this Gauss point, we had evaluated the value as 849.1833. Then the corresponding weight for this point was nothing but 1 and 1, so that I will have to substitute here, 1 and 1, and then finally I will have to multiply this with this, so that had again come as same value, 284.1499 and 849.1833. And once this is done, I just need to sum them up. And then once I sum them up, I know that this will be my final integral value. So this is how we can very easily tabulate all these values in order to avoid any confusion, because here it is fine, we had only n equal to 2, but and this is just the one dimensional integral. Once we go to two dimensional integral, and then as our number of Gauss points increases, it is always advisable to put it in this table form, and very easily you can evaluate the value of any integral. But remember that we can use this numerical integral formula only if the limits are from -1 to +1, that is the domain should be in terms of natural coordinate. And if there is the coordinate system is something different, then first we'll have to convert the given coordinate system in terms of natural coordinate by this mapping function, and then accordingly substitute the value of x or any other variable in terms of xi, and dx as in terms of d xi, and then we are good to solve any integral by using Gauss quadrature integral formula.